And welcome back to the Sea Story Cup 4. My name is Yata, and I'm the manager of Team Manalite. And joining me here today is one of the player's teammate, which is Cypher, from Team Fate to Karma. Say hi.
Hi.
Anyways, this next match we have here is Vortex versus Purple. Both guys have quite a strong lineup. So it's going to be an interesting match. What do you think about your teammates' decks, since you probably have more insight?
I think they're actually relatively even, looking at the deck picks. They both brought Priest and Druid, and then the difference is Vortex has a Warrior, which I'm not sure what Warrior he's brought, and Purple's brought a Mage, which he was playing Tempo Mage yesterday, so I assume he's brought Tempo Mage again. So I think they're fairly even lineups.
So you don't have anyone who you would prefer to win? Well, of course, but not being biased, you know, who has the edge with those classes?
I think possibly Purple, but it's just because he can pick the Tempo Mage into Druid, and that's a very strong counter. And the Warrior's kind of a good all-round against these Purple's lineup.
Okay, and do you agree with the bans?
I think so. I think the Warlock ban is interesting. It's like it was probably between Warlock and Druid. I think Vortex's ban on Paladin, kind of a have to do, or Purple's banned on Paladin.
Okay. So yeah, what kind of Warrior is this actually? Is it a Patron?
We'll have to see, because the players could have switched up their decks.
Oh right, well.
So I think yesterday he was playing Control, but we don't know. I would make the assumption he's playing Control again.
That would be interesting if he actually switched. I'm actually very curious if any of the players switched their decks for this round.
Because you did have to submit the decks before you entered. So you submitted both at the same time. So there's no kind of mind games looking at what people play, trying to counter.
And it's kind of hard since you don't know who you will be facing against in the top eight. So it's kind of pointless somewhat. Yeah.
The thing I would expect to see is people, if they ran Tempo Mage or Hunter, is switching up the traps. Because Purple yesterday, he was running like Counter Spell and Mirror Entity. Maybe today he's got a duplicate in there just to mix it up.
That would be very interesting to see, actually. And then the reactions of the players were like, wait a minute, this wasn't here yesterday. So, yeah, we're just getting into the match right now, yeah?
We already started, I'm a bit behind.
Oh, doesn't matter. So, yep. The match should be up right now.
There we go.
And we have both the players' hands.
Interesting, they both started with Druids. Mm-hmm. Looks like one of them had an Innervate Shade start. And it'll be against a turn 4 Emperor. So, yeah, both very strong starting hands with Innervates.
So, it's just the standard midrange Druid.
So, but yeah, no aggro Druid here. Yeah. Two very honest decks. It looks like Purple's had a much more aggressive start, though.
Oh,
but
yeah.
But Vortex will get the Innervate Emperor, which is absolutely huge value.
On this
and
hand,
he will be able to follow up with the lore. So if the game goes long, I think Vortex will have an advantage. But he has to survive Purple's really aggressive start, which looks really difficult at the moment. So Emperor goes down.
We get a really nice discount on the lore, so yeah. And part of the combo.
Ooh, and that war top deck's really good.
Ooh.
Druid has no hard removal. Dealing with those like really health-heavy minions is really, really a struggle for them. Ooh, and he's trading. If I was him, I might have even gone face there, because he has to trade back into one of the 5/5s, and it will probably be the Shade. So I might have gone face there if I was going to attack, but...
Oh.
The second discount isn't too much of a worry when you kind of... have that much, that aggressive of a start.
Well, he doesn't have much choice now. I mean, it was a really nice top deck, in a sense that he can actually play
something
this turn.
And it wasn't a hero power pass.
Yeah. Oh, he decides to clear the
Aspirin. And this really pays off. He doesn't know it, but it means that the he can't coin Boar.
Yeah.
But that Keeper top deck.
Top deck, yeah.
Next best thing.
Well, he will get the lore up. And he draws another one, so he's got a...
He's got
play
cards.
Next
He's got cards
well.
For days.
Yeah. Okay. Let's see. We're probably going to see the war.
The coin war, yeah. And then I wouldn't even trade. Just full smork, go face.
Yeah.
The Druid matchup is interesting because you can never let your opponent get too big a board because suddenly they innervate, force four, and you're gone. So you have to keep their minions in check, but leaving one on board isn't too bad. So there we go. We see the Ancient of War coming down. He does have a silenced answer it, but he doesn't have much to play with it.
Yeah. It's like, yeah, swipe is really not that good on this board. Like, yep. Not at all.
There'll be 2 5 health minions, and he can't finish it off with a hero power.
Yeah. If this was an Azur Drake, though, that would have been a nice swipe.
Yeah. No, he'd still be one mana short, though. It's there's no good.
Well, I mean, if the Ancient of Lore was in Azur Drake.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think you just have to play as defensively as possible. I think you...
He's facing a lot of damage. He even has, like, potential lethal next turn if he top decks Savage Roar, if he doesn't clear, so...
I think my play would be I'd keep her the, keep her the 5-10, make
and
a trade
yeah.
then just use up one swipe on the 2-4. It feels terrible to do, but then next turn you can swipe the Lotheb and possibly get a board clear.
Yeah, that's the best line of play here. Oh.
Alright, he's going to go for a Wrath Hero Power, it looks like.
Well, how can he do that since
it's
he says it's
drawing.
2 mana, so he... Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I think his plan is to double swipe next turn now. He's leaving that at 2 health, so the 2 swipes will be a full clear.
Clear, yeah. So we see...
So this might have been the better line of play. He's taking more damage now, but he gets a board clear now. The thing is, we now see the Savage Roar in Purple's hand. So the second he gets a board that sticks with Vortex on 10 hit points, it's just, the game's going to end then. So it's interesting. He's kind of got a choice. He can clear this 3 damage hero power and put up the Shredder. Or he can play the Shredder, the 2 drop, and just hero power.
Oh, wow. 2 BGHs.
That's interesting. I don't think he was running that yesterday. He was in my group. I can only remember seeing one.
Oh, man.
So maybe he's expecting more handlock today.
Yeah.
Or maybe there was so much Control Warrior yesterday. Hello.
Interesting.
Vortex is going for more draws.
Yeah. Well.
Gets to innervate, but he's got nothing to play with it.
With, yeah.
And these 2 wild growths, he's drawn them at practically the worst time.
So is he betting? Oh no. He's just.
And that's just going to be game. 2 Savages roars. Play. And what's really nice is he didn't reveal he was playing
the 2 BGHs.
The 2 BGHs.
Yeah. Sneaky, sneaky. Oh, and he top decks the Force of Nature. A little. Sort of BM.
Innervate Shade is a very good one drop. Snowballs out of control so many times.
Yeah.
So let's think, what does Vortex have? Because his Paladin was banned. Paladin's the natural counterpick into the Druid.
Mm-hmm.
So now he's got some tougher choices to make. Like, Control Warrior is historically a bad matchup against Druid, but people are saying it's better now. And then he's got Priest. I assume it's a Dragon Priest, because that's what he was running yesterday, which is kind
likely,
of...
Yeah.
It's kind of 50-50, people say.
But since we did see the 2 BGHs, it is possible that we see some other surprises from him as well.
All right, so you see the Control Warrior, and instantly we have a great hand.
Oh, yeah.
You have the War Axe, you have low drops.
Oh, the BGH would
be... But this hand from Purple, Wild Growth into Shredder, and then you have it innervate. If you get one of your 7 drops, that's an amazing curve.
Oh, the BGHs would be really good if this was an aggro druid for the Fel Reavers, but that is unfortunately not the case here. So
he mulliganed away his Armorsmith and such, just keeping the War Axe.
Well. So we're going to see the Shade?
Yep, this is a perfect curve. Innervate Shade, ramp turn 2,
amazing.
Turn 3, Shredder. And this is the one thing that he can't War Axe. And this curve keeps getting better and better for Purple.
Oh, yeah. Damn.
So we just see an armor up pass here. He might equip the weapon. There we go, armor up pass.
That's a very scary board again.
Yep, you do have, for that second Belcher pickup, you can go, you can weapon this turn, then coin Belcher in the Belcher, and you can kind of stop taking that damage.
Yeah.
And the Druid is low on cards. If you stabilize for a second as Warrior,
yeah,
you can put yourself in okay position, and that's a terrible drop.
Yeah, that
the
is
Shredder.
A really bad drop. But he keeps getting a 5-drop, so what do you think? He's gonna
if he's
go
attacking,
for
I would like to see a Lothep, just because like Bash and
it's
Slam can't
yeah,
be
yeah,
used.
Yeah.
Like Belcher is fine as well. Even Druid the Claw as Taunt, but I'd like to save the Druid the Claw back. It's more flexible. You can use it to charge down something if you have to. There we go. All four weapons. You always want a couple weapons against Druid, but having all four, you just don't have the time to use them.
Yeah.
So it looks like he wants to coin Belcher. He has a tough decision to make with the weapon, though.
Yeah.
Like, he'll probably attack in with the 5-5 and then the 3-5 to the 1-1, which leaves the Belcher at 1 health if he attacks in with the weapon. But you might want the Death Bite for next turn. So you can see he's thinking about it. I think it's better to just pass here.
Something something's happening
on
the other stream.
Yeah, so he's really roping thinking about this. This is surprising. Control Warrior can be a deck you just play on curve turn after turn. But when you have all of these weapons, like figuring out when you can play them. It's a force of nature for the Druid.
Wound
not
Feast.
Good yet. But this Lothep, this is...
This just might seal the deal there. So he can't use Brawl even if he top decks it.
Yeah, Brawl was one of his outs. Oh. And that Nefarian, that doesn't do anything.
Yeah.
The Belcher is basically the most defensive play. You're going to block 8 damage from the Druid. It gives you more time. Like if you top deck the Brawl next turn, you still have a chance.
To stabilize, yeah.
But it's basically just that one out now for the Warrior.
Yeah.
So I think I'd like to see a draw, maybe.
Yeah,
probably draw on the 1-2.
Cycle to try and get the
if you get a shade or something,
piece.
You can use your hero power to push the damage.
There's the
combo. That'll be useful in a couple turns. And I like this, not playing a Druid of the Claw, even though you can. Just don't overextending into the Brawl.
This is so unfortunate, though. I mean, not a single Execute, nor a Shield Slam, nor anything on the Vortex's side. Yeah,
just...
There's no Brawl either. Damn.
Yeah, the Druid just curved perfectly. Like, Vortex had the early weapons, but against a Stealth Shade of Naxxramas, you can't use them. So Shuya Maiden is your... Do you even survive on board?
I don't think, 11? No. There's no way with the Savage Roar. Oh, is he going to be him?
GG. And this means that Vortex is only going to have his Priest left.
Which
will be interesting. It's actually, if it beats the Druid, it's good against the Tempo Mage. And what's the last deck from Purple? It was a Priest Mirror. So the Priest does have the potential to 3-0. It has no really bad matchups.
Yeah.
And this is probably the worst one for it. So if he's able to get the win, he's got a reasonable chance.
That's good to hear. I always enjoy watching as many matches as possible. It's more exciting that way.
Yep. There we go, queuing up with the Priest. The opening hands will decide a lot, I feel, in this matchup. And the Agent, that's my favorite card to have against the...
So, that is a pretty good hand. Well, he's just missing a dragon to have the... Oh, but the Druid again.
Yeah.
With the Wild Growth.
This is very smart, not playing the Whelp turn one. It feels like such a...
Yeah.
Get the 2-4 out.
He wouldn't have a turn two play.
Yeah.
A reasonable one, at least.
But this curve from Purple's alright with the Wild Growth. Oh, a Chromagus. I did not expect that. All right, so just getting the wealth down. He's not playing into keeper, which is good.
Mm-hmm.
Like if he had played the Valens Chosen, it looks like a very strong play. But the keeper just takes that kind of 4/8 minion and turns it into a 1/4, which is so much worse. This is an excellent top deck from purple.
Oh wow!
4/6 taunt.
He has to go with the Valens Chosen now in order to clear
the. Yeah, the silence isn't as big as a drawback now.
Yeah,
it's not on curve, and he's getting the value out of the Chosen right away.
Yeah,
this is the right way around.
Yeah,
left with a 4/4 rather than a 4/3. All right, so he's got. I guess swipe is the option here. You don't really want to play a keeper because you know turn 6 is coming up, and keeper is the best minion to grab.
To grab for with the Cabal
Shadow Priest. The Dragon Priest tend to run 1, just to make people play around it. They need the 6 slots for dragons and such.
He does decide to go with the keeper. So, do you think, maybe just go for the face?
I think you Blackwing Corruptor. Like, you could, if you go face, you're broadcasting that you have the Shadow
Cabal.
Priest,
and
he's just going to trade away the 2/4.
But there's, like, literally no targets that he can steal otherwise, so.
You still have the Sylvanas on curve, though.
Yeah, that is pretty good. Oh, and the Chromagus, that will be a really good draw. Oh, that is a big draw.
There we go, Sylvanas. This forces him to play removal this turn.
Oh yeah.
We'll probably see Wrath for 1 into Swipe.
Pretty much. Oh.
He's going to use the Hero Power. This is interesting.
Mm-hmm.
I might have cycled here and not taken the 5 damage, but he's a... Because there's not really anything in the Dragon Priest deck you have to remove right away, apart from Ysera, and Wrath isn't the helpful card in that situation.
That was a pretty good draw.
That was an excellent draw. So he's got to decide whether or not to play the Whelp, because he's going to play the Chromagus next turn, which means he'll be out of dragons.
Yeah.
So he plays it for tempo. He thinks he's got enough kind of gas in the tank. This means if he plays a Chromagus and then draws into sort of the Blackwing Corruptor, you won't get the effect of it, which is a possible downside.
Yeah. Well, so I guess we will be seeing maybe Ancient of War, just so that he can deny your opponent.
It's incredibly risky against Shadow Word Death, is what Purple's thinking now.
Oh, yeah.
Like, but if you play the 5 drop with the Aspirant, then you're playing into Cabal Shadow Priest, so you've got to kind of pick which. What's the worst case scenario?
Yeah, you do want. It's not a really big setback if you steal the Aspirant at this time.
Yeah, whereas, a 3 mana card to remove a 7 mana card is such a huge setback, especially when you're behind on board. So he's mousing over the BGH. You might want to play Druid of the Claw BGH, which is very smart. It only dies to Holy Nova. But apart from that, it has potential to trade up.
It does sound reasonable. Oh, there we go. We have a Power Word Shield for the potential Chromagus. If it does survive.
I think you just want to throw it down this turn, though. Like,
Because
otherwise, what you're going to do this turn, you just play the Cabal Shadow Priest, attack in and heal. The Chromagus is such a bigger tempo play.
Yeah, I know. And we do know that the opponent does not have an answer for it, so that's good. Unless he draws into a Savage Roar, that would be really bad for
that's
Vortex.
That's what Vortex is thinking right now.
Mm.
But there's really nothing he can do to play around it.
Well, he will lose a win condition, though, because he will be out of the combo pieces. He will only have 1 Savage Roar left in his deck, so that might not be as bad.
There we go, Cabal Shadow Priest down.
Oh.
And he's making the attack just to get value from the Hero Power.
He does not go for the Power Shield yet. He saves it for the next turn. But we will be seeing Lothab potentially.
Yeah, and Lothab will ruin Vortex's plan. He saved that Power Shield to get the combo with the Chromagus, an extra card. And we might see, if Lothab comes down, we might see the death go on that, so he can Chromagus Power Shield next turn. which will be a bit of a blunder because then he won't have the death for the Ancient of War. But it's going for the war this turn.
Mm-hmm.
And the aspirant just playing on curve.
So I suppose we will need to see
He goes for the hero power.
Shadow Word Death this turn. Or do you still go for the Chromagus? What do you think?
I think you have to Shadow Word Death. The value is just so big.
Oh, and this.
Oh, this is
really
perfect.
Good. Perfect. Yeah. Very good draw. And well, yeah.
This is going well. He does get the Ancient of Lore, so he can start fishing for more of those combo pieces if he wants to. And he throws it down right away. He knows he needs more in his hand. That innervates really good.
Mm-hmm. And a Shade, so he can...
Shade as well. Shade and Lotheb are very good to play together against both Priest and Paladin, because that means Holy Nova and Consecrate can't remove them. So I'd...
Yeah.
He could potentially save it.
Oh,
but he's just going for the tempo play now.
That's actually really good for him. Even though he doesn't know what his opponent has right now.
Yep. And that's a good draw as well.
Yeah, that can stop some damage. So he can just play Chromagus this turn and...
Play the Ancient, play Chromagus. Trade with probably the Lotheb.
Yeah. Are you mocking me? And go face with a Cabal.
Yeah, the thing is Vortex is kind of out of cards now, and the Druid still has still a cycle in his hand with the Wrath, as well as Shade. Mm-hmm.
And if he does draw the combo, it's kind of gonna
Well, Vortex still is at full health, so the Druid's still gonna need to draw into some more minions
before he can
finish the game.
No. I'm just saying he will be able to clear the Chromagus if he does, so...
He's thinking about the Powered Shield,
keeping
the dragon hand.
Hmm.
That's an interesting line of play, actually.
He's really afraid of that combo.
But you've already used both agents, both corruptors. I think just throwing down the Chromagus now for the value.
Yeah, I mean,
the right way
six
to go.
Mana power which he'll feel so bad. Oh, he does decide to. Oh, that is a greedy play.
It is a greedy line of play, but you're at 30 health. You've got a taunt up. Like you can afford to take a little bit of time if you want.
That is true, yeah. And purple does draw and semi-answer for Chromagus just to stop him from completely snowballing the game into Vortex's favor.
Yeah.
So,
how would you do this turn? Because there's the option of Wrath, Hero Power, and Trading, which is the kind of efficient way to go. But you do want to cycle through your deck a bit more as well.
I would kind of go for the clear. I mean, the priest has a hard time dealing with one health minions, and I don't
think
he's
seen
running
either
Holy
Nova
Nova
yet.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
You put the shade out, and you leave the 5/5 on one hit point.
Oh. Okay. Didn't see this one coming.
I really like this play.
Oh yeah.
He's playing more around Holy Nova, and he's getting the draw from the Wrath.
A Cabal would be a pretty nice.
He's already played one, though. I think the Dragon Priest tend to stick to one.
Oh!
It's not amazing here, though. I think you hold on to it and you go with the Chromagus play.
Yeah, you kind of have to.
But he's got to think about the Force Roar combo now.
It is quite dangerous.
It is lethal if he has it in hand.
11. Yeah.
But I like this.
No,
this
it's actually one of lethal.
Is it?
Yeah. 29 damage.
Much safer then to go for this line of play.
Yep. So was this a...
A Dark Cultist. Probably not the best one.
Not the best one, yeah. Oh, there's the Savage Roar. Oh, he's going to be
And
late.
Purple's done this right away.
Oh, yeah.
I think you have to go all face.
I think he...
He's thinking about it.
Mm.
You set your opponent to one with three minions on board. Like, you force your opponent to have multiple removals to deal with this board. And Priest doesn't have any burst, so even though he's 6 damage from dying, there's nothing he can really draw. Like
Unless Chromagus multiplied his Mind Blast.
That'd be an interesting tech card if we saw a Mind Blast.
Oh yeah.
He's going for the trades. This is a safer line of play.
Mm-hmm. And he still has potential lethal next turn if he draws another Savage Roar, which he does still have in his deck. Oh, there we have Nova. Nova, yeah.
This is really nice. You get to take a clear away that 5/1. It means you're in a much you're much safer from dying next turn. And you put both of those into Light Bomb range, which is an even bigger deal.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
Dr. Boom.
Dr. Seven.
That's going to be a tempting play for sure.
It is kind of turn 10, but hey, still is good.
I hope he was planning to Hero Power and not play the Shade, because he shouldn't have traded away the the Aspirin first. But this works out well for him, because...
Let's see the Boom Light Bomb power.
Two and four. So that's a bit above average.
A bit above average, yeah. So can't the Priest stabilize right now? Ysera, how good would Ysera be here? Oh, that Velen shows I can clear the...
Ysera's almost too slow.
Yeah, yeah, it would be too slow for... Because we know what the opponent has right now. Those are some
strong
cards.
The Priest is very sad right now. He hasn't drawn any of his clerics.
Yeah.
Because getting that draw kind of in the mid-game while getting value from your hero power is how the Priest kind of
snowball
keeps going and well, stays ahead in card advantage. So I imagine he's just going to Emperor and play the 4 drop here. It's just the overall strongest turn. He is thinking about it, because he's just seen a Holy Nova. And the 4 drop offers a trade with the 3-6. This does give some outs to Vortex, though. If he had drawn a Holy Nova, it would have been lethal.
It would have been lethal, yeah.
Chill Moth.
Oh, damn.
That's a really good draw. It can protect him next turn. And Vortex is out of range of anything now. At 9, Force
pretty
of
much,
Nature.
Yeah. Oh, that's a...
That's
bad
kind
draw.
Of a dud.
Yep, yep. And Vortex takes the game.
That was a really, really close one. I kind of... wonder how the game would have gone if he had just gone all in the turn that Chromagus was on the field.
Yeah, it would have probably turned out better for purple, I think. Well, we'll see. So, Vortex making a comeback. Are we going to see a sweep?
And he decides to play the mirror first. Interesting. I think that's kind of saying he doesn't think the tempo mage is
favored. Yeah.
The cleric in hand, that's always a very nice start.
Very
especially
good, yeah.
In the mirror, you can't play your whelps, you can't play your agent, because you just offer a free draw to your opponent.
Very slow start, though. I mean, besides the Northshire cleric.
That's a nice pickup.
Yeah. That's gonna...
Ooh, he offs the pass.
What can actually priest... Oh, well, Shrinkmeister, eh? That's the only... think that can actually stop it.
Yeah, you play the cleric now because you have the balance chosen to follow up. So he has multiple options. He could have coined 4-drop and a 4-drop. He knows this is out of range for any removal from the priest.
Yeah.
So I think with this heavy of a hand, you might save your coin and just go for the balance chosen now. Because if you coin the Twilight Guardian now, what is your next turn? Balance Chosen and Twilight Whelp. But he offers to go for it. This does protect the cleric, and if he attacks in, he gets a heal. Which gets him a card. Another Twilight Guardian, interesting. We'll see if he goes for the tempo play and puts down the Twilight Guardian, or if he decides to heal and get value from the cleric now. Or you can Velen's Chosen and deal with the 3-6, but you give up your cleric then.
Yeah.
And you don't kill the 3-1.
Very hard turn, I mean.
I don't really mind falling behind on board, because you have the Sylvanas in hand, and Priest has no way to silence the Sylvanas, so even if you're a little behind on board, and you play Sylvanas, it offers you that swing back. So I wouldn't mind him taking a card draw here. But I think all lines of plays are viable.
Well, this way, the opponent can't really deal with the... Oh, He does decide to trade. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. We see the light bomb pickup from purple.
Yeah. It's actually not too powerful in this matchup because almost all of your minions have higher health higher than health, they do yeah. attack.
But it is a way to deal with the Sylvanas if.
That's true.
If it's on an empty board, but yeah. Well, it with clear most of his own minions anyway. Okay.
Huh.
That's a very.
Why did he want to buff up the 2/6, especially two turns from Cabal Shadow Priest?
Hmm.
That's very interesting.
He might have misplayed, I think. He did.
He is playing around Vol'jin, is the thing. Because Vol'jin on the. Would be the 3/9. That would be a huge swing.
Vertex does play Vol'jin? Because we didn't really
see
it.
We didn't see one, so it's possible he doesn't play one. With the potential reason for Purple's play. I think we should just see the Azure Drake here.
Yeah.
It's consistent with his last play, playing for tempo. And then trading to the 3/6. If you go for the cleric draw, it's only good if you draw something to play, like another Powerwood Shield or a agent. Yeah, I like this play.
Mm. The Shadow Ward Death won't do much right now.
It will get some huge value, though, in the next turns.
Mm-hmm.
So you see the Mirror Azure Drake coming down for purple. He gets his own Sylvanas.
Are we going to see a Shadow Ward Death own Sylvanas to get another Sylvanas?
He can't do it next turn, though. He'll have to wait one turn.
Yeah.
But that's an absolutely huge swing if that happens, especially in the Priest Mirror. So he doesn't want to play Sylvanas, it looks like. Because Purple would trade both minions in and just get and Vortex would just get the 2/1, which isn't amazing value.
Hmm.
There's no very clean plays here. All right, this is good. Ooh, and the Ysera enters Purple's hand. Another very powerful card in this matchup. It can't be Death. It's on that perfect 4 attack. Vol'jin's kind of the only answer, or Sylvanas. But this turn's very difficult for Purple. Because if you play your own Sylvanas, you risk... You risk Vortex having his own death and going for the 50-50 to steal it.
Yeah.
But I think it might be the right play. It looks like Purple's going for... This is actually a very tricky turn. I don't know what I would do here as Purple. I think just throwing down the... Sylvanas is the correct play, because if you trade Sylvanas's, Vortex Sylvanas will steal first, take the 2/6, and then Purple will steal it back. So it's not really the end of the world. You just traded your Sylvanas for Sylvanas.
So it's equal value. And
this is a much easier turn. You can get the draw. You should have drawn first here, but there's not really a 4-drop you ever want to play above the 3/6 dragon, so not a strict misplay.
Still haven't seen any Blackwing Color Corruptors. So I guess
Sylvanas is really appealing.
I have no time for games.
And it looks like must play Twilight Drake down as well.
Oh. He can draw a lot of cards this turn.
With the Holy Nova.
Oh yeah.
That might be the winning play. Like just.
It most likely will be. Yeah.
Do you deal with the Sylvanas this turn? It's possible. You just attack the 2/3 and the 1/3 into the 2/4, Holy Nova, take two cards, and then trade your 3/6 into the Sylvanas.
Yep. He's just trying to calculate
Yeah, he's got to make decisions about whether he wants to clear or whether he wants to draw. He already has card advantage, so it might not be as big a deal for him to get more draws. It looks like that's the line he's going for. He'll trade the Cleric into the 2-1 and then trade in the Sylvanas. He's maybe putting the Twilight Drake down first now.
Oh, so he's...
Ooh, he wants to go for a heal.
Heal, yeah. Oh, and he goes face.
I like this. There's no way this play can really be punished. Like,
yeah, it's out of range of Holy Nova, and Sylvanas doesn't really have any.
Yeah, so he probably has to go for the trade and the steal anyway.
Yeah. There's actually no way to deal with this there, and we see a dream. Yeah, I don't.
This is interesting.
Do you maybe? Can you actually do like trade everything into the Ysera and play the light bomb? Would that kill it? That would kill it, right?
Yes, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's
I think
exact.
That's the play.
That's absolutely the play because you also kill off all of your own minions.
So
kill off your Sylvanas. You give him no value.
And you can still
drop down your Dark Cultist and have a board.
Yep.
And that dream is a card from Purple, who's probably not too happy with that. You'd prefer a higher value one. Awakens is always the best, but a Drake in this matchup as well. Still very powerful. Light Bomb is going to play the Cultist because it can't be Cabot Shadow Priest. He's not giving Purple the chance to get that swing turn.
That it was
the Aether
really
Drake's very good here. He needs more cards. Mm-hmm.
Oh, and there we go. Power Shield.
And we didn't mention the Zombie Chow coming into the hand of Purple. This means it's more of an anti-aggro deck. And I don't think Vortex is running them. He's got, like, Chromagus in there instead, which makes him more favored in the mirror.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. And the opponent does not have...
Turn.
Oh, my. That's a lot of cards. Oh,
I'd like a split on the Power Shield.
Oh, my God. Oh.
And two deaths.
Does it have any targets, though?
You probably won't have enough targets. Like, Bulges and Death kind of serve the same purpose, so it's...
We did kind of call it right now. He does have targets. That's going to be a very... No, it's not. He won't lose a card, at least. Wait, what?
I was to get...
Value. Okay.
This is a play not a lot of people would see, I think.
No. I would
it's so tempting
that.
To just dream away that 6/10 Chromagus, but then you know you have to deal with it again.
Yeah, but now it kind of has 6/13.
And he drew the Shadow with Death, so he has to answer for next turn.
Oh, that is a really good duplicate.
Yep. Let's see which minions he chooses to play out. Alright, so the Agent and the Cultist.
Mm-hmm.
I like this. Minions that are out of Light Bomb range. He knows he just has to play like he's ahead.
Yeah. Ooh, there's
Dr.
the
Boom.
Second Shadow or Death target. He will not be happy. I'm pretty sure that...
He knows the Shadow or Death was duplicated. So he knows this can be Death immediately.
Too much Death, man.
Do you go for the Volgent just to get another threat?
Yeah.
Because Ysera's already gone. It's like, what else are you going to Volgent in the deck?
Yeah, exactly.
But I wouldn't blame him for going for a Corruptor as well.
It's a big threat on the board, yeah. He does go for the...
And he plays a top deck one. I don't like this because he reveals that he has... Purple now knows the Death in hand. If he played the Death duplicated, then Purple wouldn't know what that card was. So you've got the Cabot Shadow Priest against the 2-3. That's probably the play. He's thinking about whether he wants the Power Word Shield first, see what he can get.
Mm-hmm.
A Cultist. So that fills out his curve.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, he still feels like he's playing from behind. So you cavalry, priest, cultist, go face with your 1-3. Ah, he's not. He's just putting the zombie chow down. This is interesting. He might be trying to set up a light bomb for a following turn.
Yep. So he decides to clear the zombie chow, and
he's probably thinking about not overextending.
Yeah, into light bomb. He
has 7 more cards. He could put one more on the board, force the light bomb to be used. I'd like to see a trade in heal here to play around. Actually, doesn't play around light bomb, so yeah, it's not necessary.
So, yeah.
I like that heal. Play around light bomb. Light bomb's the one comeback mechanic left in Purple's deck.
Yeah.
Because you've seen the Sylvanas. And this Corruptor, without a dragon.
Yeah, it's kind of useless.
Well, he does have a very good Cabot Shadow Priest for next turn.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, and a Villain's Chosen. Picked up.
So he's chosen in that one. Get out of Holy Nova range, but he's playing a little bit into the Shadow Priest. I suspect he's going to put the Corruptor down.
Yeah.
Oh, he decides to Acer Drake. You could argue he should have done this first. That's an interesting tech card, the Shadow Word Pain.
Oh, yeah. It's going to help standard. Him out after the Cabal Shadows Priest to his own agent.
It'd be interesting to know why I put that in the deck, because it's not a very standard card, and that is a very good draw.
Oh, yeah. Well, at least the Vol'jin will be useful.
And he knows there's a Vol'jin there.
I'm not sure he's aware of it, because he is healing it, so that's not a that's not playing around it, kind of.
He saw so many duplicated cards, he might have forgotten which one was the duplicated one.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He is not happy with that one.
So you've got a couple options here. You can pain, you can trade heal, or you could attack into the 4-5 and Corruptor it.
Yeah.
I kind of like the trade heal. It's kind of
he isn't favored.
He's very, very much not favored. It's actually one of the most one-sided matchups in the game, well, Freeze Mage against Priest.
It is a tempo mage indeed, so Priest is favored, and that is, I guess...
That's a poor hand from Vortex. He's going to have to throw it all away. Look for those early drops.
Still nothing. Well, let's see what...
And this is too high curved.
That is... Yeah, very slow, but Purple didn't get anything better either, so...
But yeah, no Mono Worm, no... Mad Scientist, so kind of poor hands from both players. We'll have to see how it pans out.
Oh, Vortex is not happy. He is not happy about that one.
I'm going to see the East Portal first.
Yeah. Let's see. Wisp? I actually thought that was in the Ruby Neck for a second. Damn.
And there we go. Twilight Guardian coming to Vortex's hand. That helps out his curve a lot.
He is very happy, though, that the opponent...
But there is going to be a coin shredder here, I imagine.
And he can follow up with the Fireball clear with on the Twilight Drake. Not looking too good for Wardex right now.
Yeah. So now he draws the agent. It's that a bit would have too been late.
Good. 3 turns ago. Or 2. Oh, 2 fireballs.
No. Oh, that's excellent draw.
That's a really good draw. Yeah.
He's got to choose which one he kills. I think you kill the Shredder just because it's such an efficient trade. You potentially give him even more power on board, but
or you give
it
him
could be a egg or something useless.
Oh, like yeah. That. You second called time. It, man.
Second time.
Purple is not happy.
Purple has gotten one of those.
That is very unfortunate. Esports.
Now, what do you play as purple? That looks really efficient, but then you have multiple 3 drops you can play. You can put up a secret, and he does. And so now, kind of mirror entity has to be played around.
He is going to be very. He does not know what it is. It's most likely a mirror entity. Oh, is he really going to be?
I think you brave it. If you looked at Purple Secrets from yesterday, I think you brave it. You know there's a chance it's not Mirror Entity, and if it's not, Sylvanas is so good.
Oh, yeah.
Because even if it's just insane. Takes the O3 against Tempo Mage, like getting that.
Yeah, the O3 is really good for him. Oh, my God. He's going to go for it.
Purple can respond with a ping onto his 2-3 and a trade, though, which is really efficient.
Oh, my God. And he does it. Damn.
Let's see if he goes for it. Yeah. How many times have you seen this?
Not at all.
And the water elemental follow-up? Yes.
Was a good play, though.
It's interesting to see the water elementals run. They're not standard. You usually run them or shredders, and he's running both.
So
Agent and Acer Drake, I assume.
Would you maybe Vol'jin, yeah.
It's a reasonable Vol'jin target, yeah, I guess. Yeah.
Very good target.
It's another reason why shredders are so much better than water elementals.
And he gets the heal, which is very important.
And he's drawing into his secrets, which is always very sad as a tempo mage.
Yeah, and no med scientist. So I guess Vortex knows what the second secret is now.
So yeah, he'll know it's a mirror entity, and he's drawn into a low-cost card he can play into it, which is very nice for him.
But what will he sacrifice for the counter
I think you trade first, you agent, and then you Acer Drake. I don't think you use up a spell yet. All right, he's deciding to use up a spell. Oh, and go for the Nova Clear. This is also an okay line of play.
It's efficient. And he does have the Wormer's Agent to sort of sacrifice.
Yep, and he's now got board advantage, card advantage, and now health advantage.
Ooh.
Ooh, but the finisher from the...
That is a good draw for purple right now.
Do you think he'll wait for turn 10 and save his spells?
I think I would. I would because I don't think that he can win this matchup. Like, look, it's just snowballed out of control completely. Yep. In Vortex's favor, so I think that's the winning play. Or well, he just go for like the Acer Drake and hope.
Acer Drake and that mad scientist. Unless he's got a third secret in his deck.
I think he must have. I mean, if he plays Counterspell and Mirror Entity, I think there's
two Mirror Entities.
Oh yeah, there must be Mirror Entity left in the deck. So yeah, that was a good play, but fortunate for.
Decides to not go for the light bombs. Just
he knows the mirror entity somewhere, and this might be the only chance to play.
Saving the cleric in hand to deal with it. Very smart.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Kind of bad.
There's
but
the
hey.
Other mad scientist. So what do you trade the 2-2 in first, then flame cannon?
Yeah.
If the flame cannon lands on you, Sarah, you can do 5.
I think, you can clear it. Just you can clear it.
Goes for the missiles first. It's a chance it kills the 0-3. Very low, though.
It really doesn't like the Sarah, though.
Yeah, he can clear the Sarah if he gets lucky.
No, he does not. I can see by Vortex's face. Or, no.
So do you give up both minions to kill Ysera? I think you have to.
Ooh. Yeah, you kind of have to.
And what is the secret? We can look, can't we?
Yeah, it is.
All right, you called it. Second mirror entity.
So
he's going for the Ysera clear. Vortex will probably throw down the cleric first just to see what the secret is. He's going to death first. He's confident it's a mirror entity and it's no two counter spells or anything. And it'll just probably play out all of the minions here, I would imagine.
Yeah, probably. Let's see. No, yeah. He just got to do that. Good.
And what does purple need to win? He has another portal. He can always get a Deathwing.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Flame.
That is very unlikely, but come on. I think it's more likely than getting
and that's
Vitality Totem two times in a row from Shredder. So.
Purple, even though he went up 2-0 at the start, and he had three chances against the Priest, Vortex was able to take it in the end.
Yep.
Really nice play from both players. There was never a turn I thought either of them made a objective misplay. Just
that was
decision making.
Big comeback from Vortex. Very nice plays, and yeah, congratulations.
So he'll move up to the winner's bracket, and I believe it's Gaara versus Ignite next.
Ignite? No, it's Gaara versus Freaky.
Versus Gaara.
Next, so... Guys, we'll see you in a bit after a small break, so stay tuned, and watch how Vortex will play in the future, so...
See you guys.
Bye-bye.